We know from the Quran and the Sunnah and the unanimous consensus of all of our scholars that there is something called a ruh inside of us, a spirit or a soul inside of us. And of course Allah mentions this in many verses. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ. They ask you, what is the human soul? What is the ruh? قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Tell them, respond to them, the ruh is from the matters of Allah, from the matters of your Lord, from the command or the knowledge of Allah. And you have not been given anything of knowledge except a very, very small amount. Now this ayah, which is Surah Isra, is very profound. We will begin our quick conversation on the ruh with it. We have very little knowledge about the ruh because Allah says so. The Bani Israel, the Yahud, they wanted to test the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They asked him three questions. One of them, go ask the Prophet, they told the Quraysh, go ask him, what is the ruh? And they wanted to quiz him. Some ulama say that the quiz was, if he gave a lot of information, this would show that he is, a'udhu billah, a false prophet, because no one has knowledge of the ruh. So this was the trap. He claims to be a prophet, ask him about the ruh. If he gave a detailed philosophical treatise about the ruh, the Yahud felt this is a fabrication, a fraud, because nobody can say anything about the ruh. So what was the response? They ask you about the ruh, tell them you have no knowledge of the ruh. So he passed the test. You understand? He passed the test because no one has knowledge about the ruh. So we have only a little bit of ilm about the ruh, as the Quran tells us about this issue. And I find it very interesting, by the way, I find it very interesting that all civilizations in the globe and all the major faiths without exception, they believed in the concept of the human soul. The ancient Chinese, the Hindus, the Buddhists, the Christians, the Sikhs, the Muslims, the Abrahamic religions, even the Greek philosophers, Plato and Socrates, and they're not even connected to a wahi. They have this concept of a ruh. The ruh is something that, pun intended, permeates through all of human civilization. All civilizations affirmed that the soul exists, except for some modern pseudo-scientific people who deny everything they cannot understand. And so they say there's no such thing as the ruh because science cannot prove it. Forget them. Everybody in human civilization believe there's something called a soul and there's something called a body. And we all understand from the Quran and Sunnah, what made Adam, Adam, was the ruh. Before that, Adam was teen, Adam was turab, Adam was clay. Before the ruh, Adam was fashioned clay. Allah says in the Quran, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِ فَقَعُ لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. After I fashion him, then I blow my ruh into him, then prostrate down to him. And the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ tells us that when Allah fashioned Adam from teen, he left the body there. And Iblis came and began looking at this empty vessel. And he began knocking on the vessel. And that knocking, that is salsal. Salsal min hama'in masnoon. Salsal. Salsal is the potter's clay that has been put into the oven and taken out. And then when you hammer it, salsala, knock knock, like when we say in English knock knock, salsala is the reverberation of the empty clay. This is what salsala. So Allah says we created man from salsal. Salsal, when you knock on it, it will reverberate, there's going to be an echo. So Iblis is doing that to the body of Adam. Adam is not alive yet. Adam is a clay, salsal. And Iblis, the Prophet said, Iblis entered and exited from this shell. Entered and exited. And he snorted and said, anything that I can enter and exit from, I can control. Anything that I can come in and out of, I can control. And he felt he is better than Adam. Now, at this stage, Adam is not Adam, he's simply clay. When did Adam become Adam? The Prophet ﷺ tells us that when Allah blew the ruh into Adam, he blew from the top down. This we learn from the hadith, it's not in the Quran. He blew from the top down. And the ruh came from the head on downwards. And when it reached the nostrils of Adam, it tickled the nostrils. What happens when something tickles the nostrils? Adam sneezed. And by that time the ruh is reaching the mouth. He sneezes. And so even before the ruh is going to the body, Adam subconsciously, without even having been taught anything explicitly, Adam says, Alhamdulillah. And this is a very profound reality that one day we will elaborate and deconstruct and talk more about the implications of this. Very profound. Without anyone saying anything to Adam, Adam says, Alhamdulillah. Where did he get it from? It comes from the fitrah. So Adam says, Alhamdulillah. And Allah Azza wa Jal responds. How do you respond when somebody says, Alhamdulillah? Yarhamukallah. So the first phrase that our Lord said to the first man, and this is again very powerful. What was the first phrase that Allah said to the first man? Yarhamukallah ya Adam. And this is the default. Wa rahmati wasi'at kulla shay. The first thing that our Lord said to our father, even before the ruh entered the whole body, Yarhamukallah ya Adam. And the Prophet ﷺ said, the ruh continued to go down until it reached the hands of Adam. Before it got to his foot, Adam tried to get up, but he couldn't, because the ruh has not yet reached down there. Adam's already trying to get up. And Allah Azza wa Jal said, خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ عَجَلٍ. How hasty is man? Just wait. How hasty is man? You have no patience. خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ عَجَلٍ. And this is a verse in the Quran, right? وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ عَجُولًا and whatnot. So this is something there as well in the Quran. Now the point being that this concept of the ruh being blown into Adam, this is something that unfortunately some innocent Muslims, inshallah they're not sinister, though no scholar believes this, have misunderstood. And they believe, and this is a wrong belief, don't misunderstand me, this is a wrong belief that no scholar has ever said. They believe that this ruh that was blown into Adam is essentially a part of Allah or divine. When Allah says that He will blow His ruh into Adam, فَإِذَا سَوَيْتُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي. Allah is saying to the angels, when I blow my ruh into Adam. Okay? Some have misunderstood and they believe incorrectly that the ruh is a spark of divinity. The ruh is somehow divine. And that there is an element, أعوذ بالله, of divinity in all of us. And you hear this amongst the new age spiritualists. You hear this amongst people that they follow interpretations of religions other than mainstream Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. And this goes back to an ancient religion called Gnosticism. G-N-O-S-T-I-C-I-S-M. Gnosticism. And the Gnostics, they were one of the earliest groups of very ancient, like 4,000 years old, 3,000 years old. And they believed, literally, that their God, that's their version, disintegrated into a gazillion bits, and each human being captured a little bit of the spark of the divinity. And you hear this phrase among some non-Muslim New Age spiritualists, oh, there's a spark of divine in all of us, right? You know, you've heard this phrase, right? There's an element of God in all of you. Where is this coming from? It's coming from Gnosticism, right? And unfortunately, some Muslims, now they've heard it maybe from Gnostics or whatnot, they read the verse in the Quran, they don't understand, and they say, oh, so Allah is saying He blew His ruh into Adam. And they don't understand. Allah Azza wa Jal created a ruh, and that ruh was blown into Adam. The ruh is not Allah, a'udhu billah. Adam does not have, a'udhu billah, divinity. Adam is makhluq. The ruh is makhluq. The ruh is not khaliq, right? And Allah Azza wa Jal ascribes things to Himself as a matter of honor. When Allah says, His house, the house is created, the Kaaba. When Allah says, His messenger, the messenger is created, not the creator. When Allah says, ناقتullah wa suqiyaha, the camel of Allah, because the camel of Salih, right? ناقتullah, the camel of Allah. Allah calls the naqa His naqa. Obviously, the naqa is it created or creator? What is the naqa? It is created, right? Of course it is created. Anytime Allah ascribes something to Himself, and it is a physical object, realize this is an ascription of honor. Allah wants to honor this object by saying, this is mine, my abd, wala maqama abdullah, my rasul, rasulullah, my house, my camel, my ruh. It doesn't mean, a'udhu billah, that a bit of Allah entered Adam. A'udhu billah. No Muslim scholar says this. It's just a misunderstanding that some Muslims, they have taken from Gnostics and they believe. Understand, when Allah says, I blew my ruh into Adam, He is saying He created something very amazing. And it's so amazing, Allah says, this is mine, my ruh. You understand? Right? The ruh is created. It is not a part of Allah. And it is an amazing creation. It is a blessed creation. It is a creation we will never understand. So Allah says, this is my creation. This is my ruh. So then Allah says, when I blow my ruh into Adam. So Adam's ruh was created directly by Allah. And that's why Allah says in the Quran that قُلْ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. Adam's ruh, Allah created it. And as an honor to Adam, Allah Azza wa Jal, in a way we will never understand, we don't think about these things, He blew the ruh directly into Adam. The ruh is created, the body is created, Adam is created. Understand this, right? Allah, in a way we will never understand, nafakha. Allah blew the ruh into Adam. And Adam becomes the human being.